Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Veena Asmano from VeenaAsmano.com. Today I'm making an entremet. It's a mango mousse cake. It's a very simple, easy, eggless recipe. I'm using agar agar. And that's why this is even easier than it normally would be actually, because agar agar sets instantly. Jello takes a few hours in the fridge to freeze. This one literally freezes in a few minutes in the fridge. So that's why this whole recipe becomes really quickly. So if you want to make a quick entremet, you want to try this recipe. It's really simple and very easy. I will make a different version of it later, which is not with agar agar, but for now they're going to make this one and it's going to be super simple and easy. So let's get started. You will get the whole list of ingredients for this along with progress pictures on my blog. So don't forget to get the link from below this video. I'm going to start by soaking the agar agar in water for about 2 minutes and then give it a good stir. Next, I'm going to add the mango puree and sugar inside. Again, I'm going to give it a good stir and I'm going to cook this over medium heat on for about 2 or 3 minutes until the mango comes to an almost boil. You can see this. It's not going to be a rolling boil, but you can see that it's kind of really nice and hot. Next, I'm going to strain this through a sieve to make sure that I have any undissolved agar agar or mango fiber that's inside. Okay, I'm going to serve it. Now, I don't have a silicone mold, so I'm using a 6-inch cake pan and I lined it with cling wrap. So I'm going to pour half of this inside the pan and I'm going to save the other half for the topping. I'm going to put this in my fridge to chill for about 15 to 20 minutes while I prepare the mousse. I've got agar agar again in a saucepan with water. I'm going to soak this for about a minute or two and then I'm going to add in my mango puree. Again, this is for the mousse and I'm going to cook it and kind of concentrate the flavor but also activate the agar agar. And you see that? I'm going to remove that out and I'm going to let it cool. Now, it's very important that you strain it and cool it as well. It's very important that you don't put hot mango puree in your mousse. Otherwise, it'll all the whipped cream will deflate. So I'm going to let this cool. Next, I'm going to prepare my cookie crumbs for the base. So I've got just some graham cracker crumbs and I've put 1 tablespoon of sugar and some butter. Now this, I have a sleeve. If you don't have a sleeve like this for your pan, it's okay. You can just use your spring foam pan and then run a knife right through it. So I'm going to use a cello tape to stick it to the side so it doesn't move on me. And I'm going to pour the cookie crumbs right there. I'm going to use the base of a measuring cup to press down. Because this is going to be the base, you want to make sure that it's nicely pressed down. I have whipped cream and powdered sugar, which I'm going to whip very nicely until it stiff peaks. Once it stiff peaks, then I'm going to fold in the cooled mango puree that we just prepared with agar agar. Now you want the mango puree to cool, but you don't want it to set. So you can see it's not completely, it's not warm, it's not the same, but it's not completely cold as well. That's why it mixes very easily into my cream mixture. So now this is my mango mousse ready for the pan. Okay, I'm going to put this aside and I'm going to bring out the jello that I have in the fridge. As you can see, it really doesn't take long to set because it's agar agar. It sets very easily. Now, I've got my mango mousse, which is going to go in there. I'm going to spread it. I'm going to add my jello right in the middle, and then I'm going to surround the rest of the mango mousse all around it. I'm going to use a spoon to make sure I have no gaps. You want a nice smooth coverage, okay? So make sure you press down a little bit with the spoon if you have to, but make sure that you have no gaps and bubbles over there. I'm going to use an offset spatula to make sure that I get a nice smooth top. Now you can put this in the fridge to chill for about 10 minutes, but I'm going to just pour the remaining. Now this is the first jello that we made. Remember, we put half in the pan for the center and the remaining is what we did over here, and I just poured that right on top. And now I'm going to chill this for 4 hours. Now it's very important that you chill this properly, because even though the agar agar sets nicely, it will taste much better if you chill it. Okay, I'm going to remove the pan, I'm going to remove the bottom paper that I have, and I'm also going to remove the sleeve. Okay, now my cake is all ready. See how pretty it looks? Now I'm going to add some sliced mango slices on top just for garnish. I'm sorry it didn't come through. I was way off camera when I did that and I didn't realize it. So I'm going to cut the slice for you and show you how it looks. It's a very simple, very easy recipe. It doesn't really take long to make because of the agar agar, but if you have to use jello, it takes a long time. So I would not recommend doing the same process with jello. I will make a similar recipe very soon and share it with you. But for now, agar agar is the way to go for this one. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you enjoyed this recipe. If you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and of course subscribe and hit the notification bell for more videos from me. I'll see you in another video. Bye bye for now.